So COVID-19 can cause an upper respiratory tract infection where you get infection of your nose or nasal passages and a runny nose, but can also infect your lungs. So your lower airways and your lungs, causing a bronchitis or a pneumonia. So that can be very severe, but the very severe cases of the pneumonias can lead to what's called acute respiratory distress syndrome, or ARDS, where there is a flooding of inflammatory juice in your lungs that prevents the breathing from happening. There's different categories of people who should be tested, right? There are people who, the most extreme are people who are having symptoms. So if you have the fever and the cough, especially if you either have traveled to areas where there's COVID-19 that's epidemic, or you've been exposed to somebody who has been confirmed to having the COVID-19, then you need to call and say, I have the symptoms that can be compatible with it, I have the risk exposure, I should be tested. There are also people who should be tested if they've traveled to the areas. They may not necessarily have symptoms, but they could develop symptoms, and again, those people should also be tested as well. Certainly, if you have symptoms, you should be tested. If you are confirmed, you should certainly be isolated away from other people to prevent transmission. If you have traveled to an area, even if you have no symptoms, the current policy is to quarantine yourself. So impose a voluntary self-quarantine for the period of time of 14 days to allow the virus, if it's there, to do anything it has to do. So those are the people who need to be separated from the rest of society. The people who are sick and risk transmission, and the people who may be harboring the virus, and we are waiting to see if they become sick or not. Because of the way the virus is transmitted, we estimate that a distance of about 6 feet or 2 meters between individuals is a sufficient distance to prevent transmission. Of course, that's hard to do in our modern society. And if you live with somebody who has symptoms, what we call a household contact, it's not just, of course, just distance. It's also inanimate objects that can transmit. Like cups and that kind of stuff. For those reasons, close contacts of people who have symptoms and have confirmed to have COVID-19, or who don't have symptoms but are still confirmed to have COVID-19, should be self-quarantined. Healthcare workers who were exposed to a confirmed COVID case could consider a self-quarantine. However, if you follow the policies of the institution properly with regards to wearing the personal protective equipment and all those other measures that are implemented, the risk of transmission should be minimal. And so that's actually what we've seen so far. For example, at the MUHC, there has been a confirmed case of COVID-19, but all the procedures that were implemented prior to that documented case were followed, were adhered quite strictly, and it looks like that was sufficient in preventing healthcare workers from getting infected.